Hey everybody, welcome back to another Staticast Gaming gameplay video. This is Crash Bandicoot 4, and this is part 5. We're going to play the Salty Wharf 1717 level. As usual, if I die like a million times, I'm gonna just cut that out of the video. Whoa. I don't even want to try and hit those guys. Just wait for those guys to turn around and you can pretty much get them in the butt. I don't know what these things are. They look like almost like little lizards or something. Whoa. Just trying to see if something's over here, but I can't really see anything.
Yeah.
One of the things I'm learning playing this game is sometimes you just have to know when to wait and take your time for in order for you to actually get through it. Wow.
Look at all that gold.
Alright, so we got through booty calls. Let's see where else we gotta go. Hook, line, and sinker. Oh, it's Tawna. What are those things? Playing as Tawna is pretty cool. Alright, so you gotta wait for those things to... those snake guys to... stick their tongue out at you, and then you can get them. That's it. Or whatever this thing is. Tawna's cool, because she has that grappling hook. And I like that they can switch things up with this game and let you play as other characters, and you have different abilities. There's a diamond. That's like the first one I think I actually found just walking around. That was close. This is so awesome that it lets you play as other characters and they actually have different abilities, so it kind of just changes things up a little bit, so you're not feeling like you're doing the same thing all the time. Why is this thing glowing here? Like, it wants me to use a grappling hook here, but it's... Oh, I can go get that box. It's weird that it's showing up there, though. I wonder if that's just a bug and it's supposed to be gone.
Oh. Eyes on target.
Oh, that's it. Okay, so that's cool. Got to play as Tawna. And rescue Crash and Coco. Okay, looks like that's the boss already. Okay, so we unlocked Tawna's timeline in the game, so that's cool. In case we want to go back and play those, it shows her perspective of the levels. Shark Man? Whoa. Okay, so now we get these sideways spikes. They do a good job of changing things up every time you go to a new level. There's always something new. Something that's a little bit harder. Oh wow, I finally got a flashback tape. Okay, so you gotta let that blow up to make those boxes appear. And you gotta do the same thing over here, but I could break every one of those, but I'm just getting out of here. That was a close one. Things look like eels. Characters in this are pretty cool. I mean, they got these unique looking creatures that are like kind of, I don't know, I don't know, humanoid animals or something. Close. Okay, back into the boat. This is tricky. They got these landmines in here. Try not to get sucked into these whirlpools. So it looks like if I move around, those guys will actually kind of change their direction, so you could use that to your advantage if you want to make them actually go into a bomb or something. You could just hide behind it. Oh, it didn't work that time. Ooh. Whoa. Whoa. Oh, barely. Barely made it. This is the end. Oh, this is the boss. Luis. Okay, so you gotta get them to go under their these tentacle things. Try to time it up so they get hit like that. Oh, that was easy. They just ran into it. Yes. Finally. Jetboard Jetty. Alright, so we finished this and okay, so we're done the Salty Wharf, 1717, and we're gonna go to Tranquility Falls, 1402. So I will see you next time, and we'll finish this level together.